Last time on the Sword and Shield anime, Ash evolved his Corvus Squire and defeated Opal. Dynamax Pokemon rampaged again, Gloria caught G-Max Kingler, Team Rocket got a Dynamax Band, and Ash destroyed Hop in a full battle, but not before Grookey and Wooloo evolved. How much will Hop improve the next time they meet, and how will Ash do in his battle against Gordy? Or Melanie? Find out right now. Episode 72. At a Pokemon Center, Ash and Gloria watch a rerun of Leon's dominant victory against B. And coincidentally, they encounter Leon, who was headed back to Hammerlock to meet Sonia. Leon invites Ash to continue their battle that was interrupted, and Ash eagerly accepts. They have a 3-on-3, starting with Dreadnought versus Charizard. Dreadnought goes for Stone Edge, but Charizard dodges and uses Dragon Claw. However, Dreadnought withstands the attack, and retaliates with Water Gun. Charizard recovers quickly though, and defeats Dreadnought using Focus Blast, surprising Ash. Ash then sends out Sentiscorch, who uses Wrap on Charizard and prepares to use Slam. Charizard breaks free, however, and clashes with Sentiscorch's Flame Wield using Flamethrower. Charizard then wins by using a powerful Air Slash. Pikachu then comes out as Ash's final Pokemon, and uses Quick Attack, but Charizard dodges. Pikachu's Thunderbolt clashes with Charizard's Flamethrower, and Pikachu follows by hitting Charizard with Quick Attack. Charizard tries another Flamethrower, but is now paralyzed by Pikachu's Static ability. Ash uses that chance to trap Charizard with Electroweb, but Charizard breaks free with Dragon Claw. The battle intensifies as Charizard uses Focus Blast and Pikachu deflects it with Iron Tail. Charizard then lands a powerful Dragon Claw, resulting in a final clash with Flamethrower and Thunderbolt, causing a massive explosion. Charizard is stumbling, but in the end, Pikachu falls, making Leon the winner. Ash is grateful for the battle, and Leon praises Ash's growth, looking forward to seeing his further improvement at the League. Gloria's a little bit concerned, but the episode ends with Ash and his team more determined than ever to become stronger. Episode 73. Ash and Gloria are doing some training when the smell of food catches Sentiscorch's attention. They trail it to a campsite and they meet gym challenger Victor. Ash apologizes for Sentiscorch's behavior, but Victor actually appreciates it and feels honored that Sentiscorch enjoyed his food. He tells them about his goal of creating the ultimate curry dex, and is specifically working on one that boosts a Pokemon's fighting spirit. With Ash and Gloria's help, they hunt for the ingredients and eventually make the curry, which Victor lets both Sentiscorch and his own Inteleon try. Fired up from the meal, both Pokemon are eager for a battle, so Ash and Victor face off. Sobble watches intently, and quickly develops admiration for Inteleon's strength. In the end, despite Sentiscorch's struggle against Inteleon's water moves, it wins by learning a new move, X-Scissor. Episode 74. Ash and Gloria are passing through ancient ruins, and here Gloria decides to catch some more Pokemon. She's just about to catch a Solrock, but someone gets it right before her. It's Avery, who's here to catch strong psychic types. Gloria and Avery have a heated argument, and it's here where we learn about Avery's past as a former gym leader. He lost his status due to his arrogant behavior, and it's now his goal to win the gym challenge in hopes of regaining his gym back. After hearing this, Ash is eager to challenge Avery. However, Sobble comes out and wants to fight for Gloria after Avery disrespected her. Avery sends out Kadabra, and it's making quick work of Sobble. Sobble tries to hide with Mist, but Kadabra's psychic abilities easily track it down. Sobble is able to land a Water Pulse, but in the end, it's still defeated. After the battle, Avery simply laughs at the two and continues on his way. Episode 75. Sobble is feeling really sad about its loss. He feels like he let Gloria down. Ash then suggests they try a new battle style that works best for Sobble, and so the training begins. It's very difficult at first with Sobble's constant crying, but eventually he's able to muster enough confidence and learns to use U-Turn during a battle against Ash's Thwacky. Toxtricity is eventually sent out as an ex-sparring partner, but he just roams off like usual. After some more training, Gloria is really proud of Sobble's hard work, and this makes him so happy that he evolves into Drizzile. And after a long day of training, Gloria and Drizzile have gotten much closer, and this seems to get Toxtricity's attention. Episode 77. While Ash and Gloria continue their travels, we focus on Hop, who is back at the Isle of Armor. He is now back to his original team, and is not only won against Opal, but has also evolved his Squirtle and Rhyhorn. He just finished a training session with Mustard, who congratulates Hop on how well he's done. He is now ready to face Mustard in a serious fight. The next day, they have a 2-on-2 battle. It starts with Luxray versus Rhydon. Although Hop has the type advantage, he's staying level-headed, and does not underestimate Mustard. Luxray uses Ice Fang for big damage, but Rhydon hangs tough. It then finishes Luxray off with its new move, Meteor Beam. Mustard then sends out Komo-O, who defeats Rhydon with close combat. Hop then sends out Farfetch'd for a clash of fighting moves. Komo is overpowering Farfetch'd, and its Scale Shot is able to knock it down. It seems like Farfetch'd is done, but Hop calls out to Farfetch'd and says he believes in him. He gets back up and lands a critical dual wing beat, followed by Leaf Blade. It then lets out a loud cry and evolves into Sirfetch'd. The two Pokemon continue their head-to-head fighting battle, and after using Meteor Assault, Mustard's Komo-O is defeated. Hop and the rest of his team are really happy for the win. Mustard then tells Hop that he's officially completed his training. Hop thanks Mustard for everything, and is now ready to continue his gym challenge. The episode ends with Hop taking a Corviknight taxi to Sirchester. Episode 78. Ash and Gloria are having dinner with their Pokemon, but Toxtricity continues to be its rebellious self and runs off. Gloria goes after it. A snowstorm begins, however, causing the two to get lost. They take shelter in a cave, and it's here where Gloria tries to have a heart-to-heart with Toxtricity, and says how she just wants them to be close like her other Pokemon. This seems to interest Toxtricity, but it's still reluctant. Suddenly, the two are attacked by a wild Mamoswine. Toxtricity tries to fight it alone, but is failing, so Gloria jumps in to defend it. Seeing this makes Toxtricity realize how much Gloria cares for it, so it finally decides to obey and fight by her side. In the end, Gloria and Toxtricity are able to ward off the Mamoswine with its new move Boom Burst, and they reunite with Ash the next day. Episode 79. Ash and Gloria arrive at Sirchester and head to the gym, but are blocked by fans. Ash manages to make his way through and meets Gordy. He challenges Gordy to a battle, but Gordy's mother Melanie intervenes. Turns out Gordy's last gym challenger wiped the floor with him, so Melanie believes that the gym should specialize in ice types now. However, Gordy refuses as he's built his whole brand around rock types. They decide to settle the argument with a battle. At the stadium, Ash and Gloria learn that Melanie is a minor league gym leader, and has had this disagreement with Gordy before. Gordy and Melanie have a one-on-one battle, using Colossal and Lapras. Melanie has a brutal battle style. Ash has never seen a Lapras fight so intensely. At the same time though, Gordy's Colossal is surprisingly graceful, able to dodge some of Lapras' attacks and strikes just as hard. This gets the audience excited. Gordy tells his mother that one bad loss won't stop him. If anything, it motivates him and his Pokemon to work even harder for their fans. This reminds Ash of his loss against Leon. Gordy and Melanie then Gigantamax their Pokemon, with Lapras using G-Max Resonance countered by Colossal's Max Flare. Colossal then uses G-Max Vocalith, ultimately defeating Lapras, making Gordy the winner. Melanie reveals that her intentions were to test Gordy's resolve, and it appears that he didn't need her help after all. Gordy thanks his mother, now feeling more determined than ever to face his next challenger. Episode 80. The next day, Gordy apologizes for the delay, and accepts Ash's challenge. The two then begin with their 3-on-3 gym battle. First up is Thwacky versus Kabutops. Its speedy movements throw off Thwacky, and it even uses Ice Beam, much to Melanie's surprise. It then uses Rock Tomb to slow down Thwacky, and then uses X-Scissor. Thwacky is almost out, but activates Overgrow to land a powerful Branch Poke. The two have a head-to-head fight, and then the match ends with an X-Scissor and Branch Poke collision, taking them both out. Next is Dreadnought versus Stonejourner. Stonejourner starts with Stealth Rocks, and gets hit with Water Gun as a result. It then uses Rock Polish to outspeed Dreadnought. The two have a Stone Edge clash that's evenly matched, but then Stonejourner follows with Heavy Slam. Dreadnought uses Jaw Lock, however, to prevent it from escaping, and then uses a point-blank Water Gun. Stonejourner continues to zoom around the battlefield to confuse Dreadnought, and then goes for another Heavy Slam. However, Ash sees this coming, and commands Dreadnought to surround itself with Stone Edge to counter the blow, hurting Stonejourner. Dreadnought then finishes it off with Water Gun. Gordy then sends out his final Pokemon, Colossal. It uses Tar Shot, getting Dreadnought sticky. It tries to use Water Gun, but Colossal dodges and finishes Dreadnought off with Heat Crash. Ash is now down to his final Pokemon, Kubfu, and it's immediately hit with Stealth Rocks. He uses Focus Energy and charges in for a Rock Smash, but Gordy lets this happen so it can get hit with Tar Shot. Colossal then uses Heat Crash, and Kubfu tries to dodge it with Aerial Ace, but it's too sticky and still gets hit. With Kubfu taking a lot of damage, Ash decides to Dynamax, and Gordy does the same. Kubfu tries to use Max Knuckle, but it's too slow, and gets hit with a G-Max Vocalith. The Burning Rocks hurt Kubfu, and it even ignites the tar on its body. Colossal goes for another G-Max Vocalith, but Kubfu holds this one back. It's in a lot of pain, but it fights through it. He then uses all of his might to push it back. Colossal's able to stop it, but then Kubfu's able to smash through it with Max Knuckle. Now Colossal is suffering from its own attack. It then goes for Max Flare, but Kubfu counters with Max Airstream. Colossal goes back to normal, and now with its speed increased, Kubfu lands a powerful Max Knuckle to defeat Colossal. Gordy is in disbelief, but impressed with Ash, and awards him his 6th gym badge. Episode 81. Before leaving Sirchester, Gloria receives a Pokejob request for the Bob's Your Uncle restaurant. At the restaurant, they reunite with
Sonia,
who joins in on the fun restaurant antics. With Sonia as the waitress, Gloria cooking with her Pokemon, and Ash attracting customers with Stentoscorch as the restaurant mascot. Eventually, Sonia notices a potential clue about the fifth tapestry of the Galar legend, hinting that the legendary Sword and Shield Pokemon might have been sealed away. With this newfound information, Sonia decides to continue her research journey once Gloria completes her Pokéjob. Episode 82. Ash and Gloria's next destination is Spikemuth, and along the way, they encounter Melanie again. They catch up and learn about Melanie's family life, and how she trained Gordy to be an Ice-type user, but he chose Rock-types instead. Seeing him get swept by a gym challenger made her get worried that he chose the wrong path. But after the battles against her and Ash, she couldn't be more proud of her son. Eventually, Melanie decides to challenge Ash to a battle to see for herself just what he's made of, so they have a one-on-one battle just for fun. It's Drednaw versus Galarian Darmanitan. Melanie fights with an aggressive battle style, which overwhelms Ash and Drednaw. They try to go for Jawlock, but it gets hit with an ice punch that freezes Drednaw's mouth, rendering Water Gun and Jawlock unusable. Darmanitan dominates this one-sided fight, until Drednaw's able to make the ice its own and turn it into a new move, Ice Fang. Impressed by Ash and Drednaw's resilience, Melanie decides to end the battle. She reveals to Ash that if he wants to have a serious battle against her, then he's gonna have to win the upcoming battle tournament in Grifflet. Hearing this gets Ash and Gloria excited, so they change their destination to Grifflet in order to compete in the tournament. And that wraps up part 7 of my Sword and Shield anime series. Let me know your favorite episode in the comments and use the hashtag ZachToshiRewrite to share your fan art of this series. Shout out to the channel members for their support and consider joining as well to watch these videos days early. Last but not least, make sure to live your life to the fullest and have yourself a damn good one.